It's basically a little bit related. Yes, in the last couple of weeks, I was digging into this fly system adapter in Silverstripe. I don't know if every one of you knows it. Yes, actually, this is my house where I lived until, yes, 1.5 years ago in the mountains. No, that's not me. I don't know actually who this is. Yes, but it's on the, yes, it's the view to Hallstatt, another World Heritage Site here in Austria. Yeah, Fly System. What's that? It's a file system abstraction library for PHP. I googled it. Yes, it's something like OmniPay for files, but a little bit easier. So it's an abstraction layer. It uses the adapter pattern. So you need some adapters to which actually talk to the file system you want to save it. And your code doesn't have to care where your file is saved, if it's saved locally or on S3, on Azure, Dropbox, FTP, Cloudinary, whatever. Yeah. So you just talk to the Fly System adapter. Yeah, it was developed in the Netherlands by Frank de Jonge. He started in October 2013, and currently we're on version 1.0.55, and it's MIT licensed. So Silverstripe has it now in Silverstripe 4, Silverstripe CMS 4, added the Fly System. Yes, it was possible to use S3 with Silverstripe 3, but it was kind of hack. Yes, you know, developers doesn't cut onions, they hack it. But now it's easier to work with other file system with remote files. Yeah. But unfortunately, you cannot use the plain Fly System adapters. You need some very thin wrappers around it because Silverstripe uses public and private files. And so you need very thin wrappers around this Fly System adapters. But it's actually pretty easy to write one. So currently, we have available the local adapter and the S3 adapter. With your module, there would be a Cloudinary adapter for Silverstripe Fly System. Yes, okay. I didn't see it on packages or in the module section. It's not yet released there. Is it in? Yes. Okay. So maybe it doesn't talk about Fly System. Yes. Okay. But there are many adapters available from the normal Fly System site. Yes, but you need to modify them a little bit to get it work with Silverstripe. And for configuring, it's pretty easy. The S3 module, for instance, it comes with a configuration out of the box. And you just need to provide the stuff you need to get S3 working. So the region, the bucket name, and if you're on your own server, you also need this secret stuff. Just configure some environment variables and you're done. Install the module via Composer, configure it, and you're done. And then Jector, a great tool, really. Replaces the local adapter with the S3 adapters. So if you want to learn how Injector works, look at the configuration in this module. It's great. Yeah, the problems, yeah, when we started with Fly System, or when Silverstripe CMS started with Fly System, I thought one more abstraction layer, it's a bit overkill for the small sites. For a small customer, where I should use Jamstack, but I'm still using Silverstripe. And updating file-related code from Silverstripe 3 is a bit of work. It's not, yeah. It's some handwork. The updater tool cannot help me so much with it. Yes, and you should know your file system. It's like the big difficulty with OmniPay. Yes, if you don't know the payment provider, you have a hard time. And then Checkdoor is powerful. It's a bit complicated. YAML can drive me crazy. Yeah, I was searching. Why doesn't it work? Why doesn't it work? No. It was intended 2 characters too much, and it didn't grab the right configuration. My editor didn't show me any error. It was formatted correctly, but it didn't work. Yeah. So, some questions I still have for it. How is it possible to add multiple adapters to one installation? Yes. There's something like that available for Fly System for replication, yes. But would it be possible to save different data object relations in different file systems if you need it for some reason? So you say user uploaded files are not on the web server, but they're put to a Dropbox where you can do something with it.
That would be hard, I think. Like, you could. I think the problem that you get is by the time the file system thing kicks in, it doesn't know which data object relationships it's with. So you could probably keep it like you could say like a subfolder. But like you could have in the asset directory, for example, this folder, that folder saved in another, and then you could say, well, put all the user uploads in that first folder, which it knows to put Dropbox. But I think you'd need to kind of take that logic and turn it into some subpaths.
Yeah, there are some possibilities. Yes, interesting idea with subfolders. Why not? Yes. So yes, thank you very much so far. Any questions from you?
So have you used the S3 adapter in production?
No, not yet. I was just digging around with other adapters. It was some basic research work.
So this is not only a question to you, but more to the whole community. Did anybody try to get this running with an S3 adapter outside an AWS environment? Yes, okay. Did you guys encounter the same problem with versioning? Because it broke my signed URL because the asset admin kept adding a GET query with a V just for the version. And this was then included because it was appended to the signed URL with a question mark. And that just broke the URL. So I wasn't sure if I really had to turn off versioning or I tracked it down in the code and I found the section. It actually was written by Ingo Schommer, and it was just commented that it's just for cache busting. So I was super confused, and nobody was able to provide some feedback. How did you guys accomplish that? So just turn off versioning.
I don't use versioning, so I can't tell you.
Okay. Tim, what about you?
Yeah, I'm just thinking. I don't think I had that problem, so I can't really give you any insight. It's not something I had to fix.
Maybe I can do a lightning talk just displaying the problem.
why not come out, please? Yes.
I just tried to recreate it and put it on Slack or something like that. Okay.
Yeah.
It's probably fair to say that I don't know how much the S3 code has been used. Like, I think it's still fairly experimental in terms of the number of times it's been used. So it's entirely possible there are still pretty bad bugs in it.
Well, the S3 code in the adapters is pretty basic. It's just defining the public URL and the private URL, and it's not really rocket science. No.